Hello guys, welcome back to TuxWriters and the last episode of Cell Viability Project. So in the previous video I showed you how to create these kind of animations in ParaView using the data that we had on Cell Viability. Let's complete this this post-processing project. And before going on, let's create these kind of plots. The plot over line, we want to see the drop of the oxygen. And if the drop threshold, if it drops below a certain threshold, then we can say that, the cells are not alive, let's say. They are dead. But in order to do this in ParaView, you can have it visually. You can have, for example, a visual inspection of the results. Obviously, you can see that I showed you how to plot over a range of data, all the time steps. And here it says that it's 40%. So we can judge on that. But just imagine that we want to report it somewhere. And this is a scientific way of reporting quantitative data. How to create these kind of plots in ParaView. So first I'll start ParaView. I open the files. I can open the group or a single file, but the single file should be one of the ones in the end, one of the steady state files. But let's open the group. I click apply. In order to make this, we can take advantage of this this filter. Yeah, that's a filter because you can also access it from here. That is plot over, where is that? Yeah, plot over line. Yeah, this one. So you can access this from toolbar also, and it brings you one line. You can use these precise point modifiers here, or you can use P and your keyboard, and it just place the point underneath your pointer. But I will simply drag it. It's not very important in this case. In real cases, when you want to report it somewhere, you should be very precise about this, about the length of the line and other specs. But here, I want to just show you how I do this. In order to make it look better, I will copy and paste the points in the y direction, so it's a horizontal line. And then I click apply. And then you see that it automatically divides the layout into two views and then plots what is visible here. I didn't talk about the visibility, but that's worth a simple, very quick discussion here. So I can close this one, and you see that this plot over line has nothing to do with this graphical window. If I just deselect it, nothing happens. But for this one, when we start to add more and more and more objects into the pipeline browser, this eye icon comes very handy because you can easily deselect it and then you can hide objects. For this case, I can also manually divide the layout and then have line chart view. And for the line chart, I will select to plot this plot over line. But you can see that we have also label here. We don't wanna have label here. So I can simply deselect it in the property panel. And this is indeed the line I've been looking for. And here you can have both together. This is the line and this is the data. How to have it externally? You can save a screenshot out of it, or better, more scientific, let's say, or more accurate, you can create another type of plots, another kind of views, which is indeed a spreadsheet view. And here you can easily have all the data related to this plot over line, point ID, and also point coordinates, everything, and the scalar value, which is into the point data, and also it can be a cell data. But you have this scalar here, scalar value here. You can simply export this spreadsheet outside and then plot this data there. Let me quickly show you. So I say quant on a desktop. So I will save it as a quant. And here I have a CSV file. I can open CSV with, for example, LibreOffice or any other Office suite you have. And then here I have the value of the scalar value. And then I can simply plot it using, for example, this is a scatter plot. As you see, the same plot here, but we have it outside. You can import it to any analysis software, analysis program that you want, and post-process it there. So this is indeed the way that you can simply plot something online in ParaView for this specific application. And according to those plots, you can simply judge and investigate if the cells are alive, if the experimental setup is okay, or if the simulation results are converged, and this kind of stuff. So yeah, that's all we wanted to discuss. In the later projects, we will talk about how to automate this. We will have same viability for different conditions, and we'll try to extract these kind of graphs out of it, but in an automated way. Instead of just opening one by one, we will ask ParaView to automatically do that for us. So that's it. Try to do this and enjoy. Bye.